Of course, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi ve sellem has made detailed statements about the end times. He says that Hazret Mehdi alayhi salam and the Prophet Jesus alayhi salam will come, and all the signs regarding that have come about. The hadith of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi ve sellem, those described as valid, have come true, and can thus be seen to be trustworthy. We can tell they are trustworthy by the fact they have come true. For instance, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi ve sellem says, there will be two solar eclipses in two consecutive Ramadans. That happened in 1981 and 1982. He says there will be a war between Iran and Iraq. He says all these things will happen in the same period, one after the other, like the beads on a necklace. Iran and Iraq went to war in October 1980. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that Afghanistan will be invaded. And that happened in 1979. The waters of the Euphrates will be stopped, and that came about too. He says there will be bloodshed and anarchy in the same area, and that happened. And the PKK terror is still going on there. He says the sun and moon will be eclipsed in the month of Ramadan, and that happened in 1981, with the lunar eclipse on the 15th day of Ramadan and the solar eclipse on the 20th. A comet appeared, Halley's comet in 1986. Then there's the attack on the Kaaba and bloodshed in the Kaaba, and that took place in November 1979, with 402 people being killed in the slaughter. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that would happen, and so it did, word for word. There is the appearance of a sign in the sun, and the huge explosion took place in the sun in 1996, the greatest solar explosion of the last century. He speaks of the disappearance of an army, and the Iraqi army did disappear in the desert in the Iraq war in 2003. There is Baghdad being devastated by fire, which happened in the 2003 Iraq war. And the corruption of smoke and fire, which refers to September 11, 2001. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that Iraq will be rebuilt, and that has happened. He even says that the Iraqi unit of currency will be invalid, and that also happened. Then there are storms and hurricanes, such as Hurricane Katrina in 2005 and Hurricane Ike in 2008. There are some 300 portents, and they have all come about. This century is one of miracles and extraordinary events, and you will notice that extraordinary things are happening. Earthquakes and other phenomena are happening in the same way. These are all portents of the coming of the Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. There are some 300 of these portents, all of which have happened. The invasion of Afghanistan, for example, is a portent of the coming of Hazreti Mehdi alayhi salam, as is the invasion of Iraq and the severing of Euphrates, which has been severed by a dam. This is a portent of the coming of Hazreti Mehdi alayhi salam and the return of the Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. There is the appearance of a comet, and as you know, Halley's comet appeared. There is a great sign appearing in the sun, and we saw the greatest solar explosion of the century. This is also a portent of the coming of Hazret Mehdi alayhi salam and the Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. There are many portents. There are many portents of this, countless numbers. These have all come about, and one very important point is that they have all happened within 20-30 years. All these portents have come true in 20-30 years. They have never happened all at the same time in history. Even our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has provided details. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says there will be solar and lunar eclipses at 15-day intervals in the month of Ramadan, and just that has happened. And what is more, in two consecutive years, in the month of Ramadan, eclipses of the sun and moon 15 days apart. We can see from these miracles, from the accounts in the Bible and the Quran, and from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we are entering the golden age. This will be a glorious age. People will laugh at Darwinism within the next 10 years. They will wonder how they believed in it. Professors and scientists will be amazed they ever attached any credence to it, and the public too. They will be amazed they were ever taken in by Satan, and be amazed at the power with which he did so. Because Satan is a weak, unintelligent entity. It's a miracle that he is nevertheless able to deceive people. But this century is now the age of faith.
Mesela diyor ki rivayette İsa bakar
In one account, he says that Jesus a.s. looks and sees everywhere in the world. When he looks, it is as if he is in a control room. One can see everywhere on the television screen if one wishes. Or you know that images can be broadcast by satellite. This is possible in Turkey too. Using bird's eye view, one can see everything that is going on from above. This is a miracle. For example, he says that the Antichrist will shout from Dikilitaş in Istanbul and it will be announced that he is dead. He says that it will be announced that Darwinism and materialism are dead. He also says that the Dajjal will shout from Dikilitaş in Istanbul. His death will be announced. He says that this will be announced by media organs in such a way as to amaze even the demons. Because he says the whole world will hear. And that is very important. He will call from Dikilitaş in Istanbul and the whole world will hear, he says. The accounts very clearly state that the Prophet Jesus a.s. will travel everywhere in the world, that oxen and the plot will not be used in agriculture at that time, a clear reference to advanced agricultural machinery. Oxen will not be used, he says. Harvesting will take place without oxen and plot. We are told that when wheat is sowed, when the seeds are sowed, an extraordinary amount of product will be harvested. And that has happened in the recent times, as you know. All these things have happened. He speaks of the greening of the deserts. And the deserts of Saudi Arabia really have turned green. People of the time would have said that was impossible. But the greening of deserts has taken place. Swimming pools have been built in the deserts. Hotels have built them. And an extraordinary decoration and beauty has come about. Whatever our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said has happened. There is a list of some 300 of these things, and I have only listed a very small part of them. And they have all taken place in the brief span of 20 to 30 years. Such a great number of portents have never before taken place in just 20 to 30 years. This is the very first time the descriptions of the end times are thus totally accurate, and it is clear that these are the words of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah. We are entering a very delightful age. Neither Darwinism, nor materialism, nor communism, fascism or atheism will be left. Only the truth. Islam will be the sole remaining faith. People will all be brothers, and love, peace and brotherhood will rule everywhere. Goods will be so plentiful. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that people will be embarrassed to take any more and will want to give them back, but they will not be taken back.